Coming to you live from the WDWNT studios in Orlando, Florida, it's See You Real Late with Tom Corless, the holiday special. Tonight, hosts of Radio Free Disneyland, DJ Middlebrow, Connor Perzicki, live from the Magic Kingdom Cabanas, a visit from Cornac the Magnificent. We've got Nicholas Cicero in the soundboard band, and I'm Scott Smith back again, and here's your host, Tom Corless.
Thank you. Thank you, fake studio audience, as always. Thank you, Scott Smith. Scott, can we put him on camera, Jason?
We sure can.
Here's Scott Smith. Welcome back, sir. It's good to have you back.
Good to be back.
And, of course, welcome to Sierra Late, or as we call it, Jingle Bell, Jingle Meh. Oh, boy. So we haven't done this in a long time. This is exciting.
But, yeah.
Unlike the Osborne Lights, this is the holiday tradition you didn't want to come back. Don't worry, we'll replace it with a fireworks show that doesn't have fireworks in it next year. It'll
be fine. Bam!
It'll be fine. But anyway, thanks again, Scott. Thank you for the introduction. Happy to have you back.
Of course. Thank you.
Nicolo Cicero and the Soundboard Band.
We're here.
We are here.
We're
this
ready.
A part of this now.
All right.
It's happening.
What did I do?
Jason Diffendahl in the video control room. First time we've done that for Sierra Late.
Yep. Here I am.
Thank you, Jason. We haven't done Sierra Late in over a year. But I figure if Goldberg could be gone for 12 years and come back and win in a minute and 40 seconds, we should be all right.
I don't get it.
It's for the wrestling fans out there, Scott. So since we've done the last show, a lot has changed. Rivers of Light. Pandora. Well, you know, one thing actually hasn't changed. The Adventurers Club is still closed. Kungaloosh!
Kungaloosh!
Yes, we thought Rivers of Light would have happened by now, but still no. Cast member preview this weekend. We're getting close.
Maybe.
Oh, boy. But the Adventurers Club, you know, that curse is real. The Edison has still not been completed. It's a shame that one guy at STK has got to look across the street at it. It's really sad.
Man, that one guy in that state. You've come to the right place.
Oh, boy. Lot going on right now. Let's dive right in. The Magic Kingdom has in-park cabanas. There's the big news this week. These in-park cabanas. The price, $650 a day for an in-park cabana. For that price, you get a private tent, drinks, snacks, custom Mickey ears, and an even greater sense of entitlement. Yeah. It's like going to Disney after hours in plastic canvas.
So basically, Tom's already got his reserved already.
Thanks. No, I don't. You know, these are a big deal, and they actually, they're available now, and we decided no one else in the community is going to fork out the money to make this happen. I figured, what better way during this, we're on for 45 hours as part of the 45-hour broadcast to benefit Toys for Tots. Let's do something big. Let's send our roving reporter, Connor Perzicki, to the Kingdom Cabanas at the Magic Kingdom. Let's rent one out. Connor has been there all day at the Magic Kingdom. Connor, you are still there now. We're going to go out to Connor Perzicki. Connor, can you hear me? Are you out there?
Yeah, Tom, I'm right here.
Jason, can we switch the feed to Connor there? All right, Connor. Really, it's really dark, Connor. You have the lights on in there?
Oh yeah. Hold on, let me turn the light on. Right there we go. There we go. Good as
that's the light that's in there.
That's the light. That's
It's not a flashlight you're holding.
Don't be ridiculous. That's the room light. It's just
Jason,
very dark
shut
outside.
Up, Jason.
It's since it's 9 plus 3. It's 11. It's very late. Very late.
Nine plus 3 is an 11.
Shut up. It's 11.
So Connor, you're in the cabana. Is it Kylo Ren in the cabana? I thought it was all Tomorrowland art on the walls. You got one with Kylo Ren on the wall?
This one's Star Wars themed. Don't know why. It was a special. Well, it was, right?
For $600, why not?
Why not? Star Wars.
They should put whatever you want on the walls.
Exactly.
There, right? But Connor, how? They're right outside of Space Mountain, right? Do you have a view of Space Mountain from there?
Oh, Space Mountain. Right. If I'll just open up the tent for you right here, but I don't.
What is that?
Oh, I think one of those dance parties started over in the Marlon stage. I can't really hear you right now.
Connor!
It's loud. Hold on.
Connor! I think we lost Connor Przycki. It sounded like the hashtag incredible super dance party was going on. Something's fishy. Anyway, we'll try again later, Jason. Maybe we can get him back. We'll try and get him back.
All right, yeah, I'll try to get a hold of him, see what's right. going on.
Yeah, please.
Must not
keep the illusion
Wi-Fi
alive, everyone.
Idiots.
Anyway, the Epcot International Food and Wine Festival is going to be kicking off in August in 2017. It should save Disney some money, as the food will just cook itself if they pop the roofs open on those booths.
It's hot.
They can't all be winners. You know, the best part is how good all those drunk people are going to smell in August. That's the best part.
In summer.
Nope.
Yeah. You know, Nick, it's going to be so hot.
How hot is it going to be?
It's going to be so hot that the taping of the chew is going to be called the drink. All downhill from here, folks. This is an interesting one. The bus stops at some of the All-Star resorts now have pizza booths in them. They are selling pizza at the bus stop. You know, 24 years in New York, the only thing they tried to sell me at a bus stop was drugs. Fairness, they tasted much better.
I was just going to say.
So now when your Disney pizza smells like exhaust fumes, at least you know why. Right? Next up for Disney, chicken breast nuggets in the bathroom. Toilet tiramisu, anyone? No, I'm going to stop with those. We haven't been on for a year. There's been plenty of stuff happening here over the last year. Hurricane Matthew came through a couple weeks ago. It's kind of a non-event here. You know, like a Inside the Magic post these days. Might as well have not. Shut up, Scott. Might as well have not existed at all, right? In fairness, you know, we had no photos of the hurricane, but we still posted about it. So I guess it makes it no better than that. So. Posted a report on dinosaur with no
photos. That wasn't Inside the Magic, though. So
yeah. Anyway.
That was a different website we're making fun of.
No, Inside the Magic did that.
No, I thought it was WD Matt.
Oh, did they do it too? Then everybody did it, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, we have not posted about it because I felt silly that our video was black and I wasn't going to put up a black video for people because I think it's stupid. But
makes sense. Yeah.
Yeah. But anyway, I rode Dinosaur the other night. Phenomenal. Everything was working. There was a bunch of new effects. Really wonderful. I was really happy with it. So go check that out. It's not a joke. It really is. You know, there's supposed to be a bar at the Tower of Terror. I don't know who I heard that from. Some idiot told me that.
Some moron.
That happened. Well, maybe it did. Maybe I was just drunk. I don't know anymore. You know, in fairness, I was playing.
You just admit it was you?
I was playing Drink Until Guardian's Tower Facade Looks Good. So I was pretty gone at the time. You know, I even woke up with a paper bag over my face. Oh, no, the paper bag was actually on the tower. I'm sorry. It was not me.
That one was pretty funny, actually.
Paper bag the ride. It's real.
Yeah.
You know it's bad when the Tower of Terror Jenga looks better than the Tower of Terror. Anyway.
Paper bag breakout.
I hope everyone's seen Tower of Terror Jenga. It literally has nothing to do with Tower of Terror. It's just like black and red colored blocks. Nothing to do with actual tower.
How many do you own, Tom?
I didn't buy Tower of Terror Jenga. Oh, I do have Pirates Battleship.
Okay.
Anyway. The backlot area and the streets of America at Hollywood Studios no longer exist. That happened. But saying they existed last year was probably a stretch. Closed are the Writer's Stop, the Streets of America, the Lights, Motors, Action, Extreme Stunt Show, the Honey, I Shrunk the Kids Playground, and several other things you didn't see for 10 years but now are really sad about.
Nope.
You know, carrot cake cookies just aren't the same when they come from the same kitchen and are sold somewhere else. They're just not the same. And there goes half the audience. Bye.
Do we have an audience to begin with?
Oh, Scott, you haven't lost a step. It's like you were never gone. Disney After Hours is the thing that happened. It was a $150 event that got you into the Magic Kingdom. After hours with little to no wait for major attractions. Sadly, it was pretty poorly attended. In fact, if you bought a ticket, you were probably...
Or yourself.
Though, probably that's what you wanted. I mean, you didn't want to wait in lines, right? Not what Disney was hoping for. But don't worry, Disney will recoup their money in bus loop pizza sales. So not to fear. everything will be fine.
Mm-mm, bus loop pizza.
I'll have some of that exhaust pepperoni, please. It was smoked in the exhaust.
When you need to eat on the bus.
The funny thing is they don't want you to eat on the bus. It's supposed to be for when you get back, because they're only open from 7 to 10.
I figured, but you know someone's going to be like,
someone's going to try.
I need a pizza on the bus.
I'm going to EMH at Animal Kingdom. I need pizza.
I need pizza fuel.
Lego released a model of Cinderella Castle a few weeks ago. It retails for $350, and it's really fun to assemble in your private cabana.
Yeah. How many of those do you own, Tom?
I sold mine. Fun fact.
Why would you do that?
I pre-ordered, and they were selling for a nice amount of money, and I figured it was a good investment, so I resold it when they first...
Wow, a scalper.
Not a scalper.
Absolutely a scalper.
People wanted it. I intended to keep it originally, but, you know, trying to be fiscally responsible.
But, you know, I got good money out of it, so I screwed someone over who wanted it the first time.
They decided to pay that for it. It's not like I went and bought all of the Cinderella popcorn buckets and then carried them on my shoulder. I bought one.
That is
with
true.
The intention of keeping it, and then I sold it. Anyway, since we mentioned the cabanas, Jason, we got that feed fixed yet? Can we get back out to Connor?
I think so. I think we got Connor now back here.
Connor,
I'm watching.
Connor, you hear me? Connor. Connor, we got no audio on you. Jason, can we fix that? He's got no audio.
Connor.
I don't know what he's wearing on his head.
We can't hear him.
There's definitely an issue with
What is he wearing?
With the feed.
I don't know. It's probably that stupid thing on his head.
He's not.
We'll come back to Connor.
Okay.
We'll come back to Connor. Throw the camera back on me, I suppose. Let's do video because audio always went so well, right?
Yeah, we should do this every day.
This is the dumbest thing.
Is anyone watching or listening? I really
there
don't
are
know.
People watching. I don't know why, but they're watching.
Toys for Tots.
It's kind of like the Magic kids, Band. You don't really need the Magic Band too, but you can if you want. Anyway.
Are you still? Why are you wearing it now?
I don't know.
Why are you?
There originally was going to be a joke about it. I forgot to write it in, and it's on my wrist. So.
Wow.
There you go. Hey, this show's in 3D. There you go. Oh, no. Anyway,
that's a great 3D trick.
Yeah. Connor, did we fix that feed yet, or should I move on?
I think we fixed it.
Oh, we did. All right, let's throw it out to Connor. Connor, you hear me out there now?
Yeah, I got you, Tom. Got
all right, it's good to have you back. What is that? Can you move your head to the side? I think I see Space Mountain. Is that a printout of Space Mountain?
I know, Tom, the video streaming quality tonight isn't that good, but you know, it's the real thing. I know Magic Kingdom.
So you're saying the quality of the video feed is why that looks like a paper printout that you just,
right, exactly.
Just knocked to the side.
It looks so clean now.
It's one of those plastic videos or those windows. You know what I mean. It's just. I'm just gonna take that down and
at it. Put the window down.
So Connor, part of this cabana thing, you're supposed to get some snacks included. Right. What snacks did they give you at this Kylo Ren cabana?
Let me see. They're right outside. I put them outside because
they're outside. Why are they outside? There's like a fridge in there, no?
Sure. Right. Exactly. So first I got a cube of butter. I don't know what they're thinking, but I like butter, so that's good. Oh, this one's really neat. They delivered it right to my cabana. It was so perfect. It was really, really delicious. I already ate it. It's empty, but it was really good. I didn't have to tip. It was perfect. So there's that.
Well, for $600, I hope you don't.
Right, exactly. What else?
Well, it's the cosmic rays they were selling to people today, I suppose.
Yeah, right. I got a can of tuna, which was on sale at the 99-cent store. I mean, I got it from Cosmic Rays. Exactly, Cosmic Rays. And I'm not even sure what the
tuna bay
is. I don't know what this is. It's not really an orange, but it's kind of like maybe a grapefruit. I don't know. It's whatever that is.
None of those are the things that are advertised to be in the cabana, Connor.
I think I got a cube of butter in Tomorrowland once.
I guess they're running out of stuff already. I mean, these are really popular.
Connor, could you do me a huge favor?
Why?
Can you walk outside of the cabana for me? I kind of want to see the outside.
All right, hold on. I gotta
and save some butter.
Yeah, let's see the outside of this cabana.
Okay, hold on. Okay.
Oh, exotic butters.
Okay. Oh, fine. All right. There it is. Okay. There. Yeah.
Is that a?
Well.
Is that a Star Wars tent?
As previously covered.
Yeah.
The Star Wars tent. What was that like? $10 on Amazon.
Yeah, Amazon Prime.
Free 2-day shipping with that. You get that?
Yeah.
So since I paid $650 for you to rent a cabana, and you clearly just bought a child Star Wars tent. What did you do with the other $639 I gave you?
Oh, hold on.
It's a nice boat behind him.
There we go. Yeah.
You owe me a $650 donation for Toys for Tots.
You're right.
Oh, that's his crotch.
We have done some dumb things here in the last 9 years. Hey, Connor, let's buy a tent. Monday meeting, let's buy a tent. Why not? Just buy a tent. It'll be great. Yeah. Buy a Star Wars tent. This'll work.
But man, that cube of butter.
But please donate to Toys for Tots. We're just making idiots of ourselves. Anyway, thank you, Connor, for that wonderful report. And I'm now out $650. A supposed, I don't know how we move on from that. We're going to supposed lewd hand gesture by Steven Tyler is also the one I'm going to give to Connor later. Supposed lewd hand gesture by Steven Tyler in the Rock and Roller Coaster pre-show was digitally removed from the attraction a few months ago. But in Tyler's defense, I think it was just him trying to count how many months delayed Rivers of Light was.
This many.
Something like that. Frozen Ever After opened, and it was good. It was good. I don't really have a joke. The ride is good. You know, a lot of fans have claimed it isn't good because there's a few blank walls, across from some of the ride scenes. You know, the walls that were blank in the Maelstrom that they loved. Anyway, you know, Donald Trump is president. Frozen ride is good. Where do we go from here? What happened? I don't know. You know, the animatronics in the ride are especially good. You know, I don't think I've seen that kind of artificial happiness, this convincing since Lou Mangiello was a thing. Remember him? He's still a thing? I don't even know.
Nope.
No. Oh, that's a shame.
I remember his quotes, though, that he made himself.
The quotes he stole himself from like other books. Anyway. Tokyo Disneyland is adding over 40 characters to It's a Small World, which is going to make it really hard to tweet about it.
Oh, that's dumb.
That's not the worst joke of the night. What? That's DuckTales in German.
That's all I got. It's good enough.
Connor's like having a rave to it. Also, it's happening right now.
Connor likes it.
What are you gonna do with that tent now? You're muted.
I'm keeping it. I'm totally keeping it.
You're gonna keep it? What are you gonna do with it?
I'm gonna do the whole show in it.
So it stays in the
tent. Ask a stupid question, get a stupid answer.
What happens in the tent stays in the tent.
It's 4x3. I can't even like sit.
I don't want to know what's gonna happen with that grapefruit and that stick of butter later.
Exotic butters.
The grapefruit and the stick of butter.
Oh boy.
Exotic butters.
So yeah. Skull Island Reign of Kong opened? Did it? I don't know. I think it did. This summer. Not sure when, but I think it's open now. The queue features scare actors that jump out and scare guests, which is a nice change from the shirtless South Americans who used to jump out and scare guests throughout the park. Different.
Oh, man. Did not miss this.
The ride vehicles are pretty cool. They're completely trackless and feature a unique driver in each truck. I think they should have just had the trucks dance around King Kong to Italian music. That's kind of more my style. I guess you can't have everything. These same trucks will get to go, quote-unquote, 90 miles an hour in 2 years when they're part of Fast and the Furious Supercharged at Universal Studios Florida. The rumor is they'll be called party buses, but it's still unknown if pizza will be sold at the loading station. Oh, man.
Too fast, too pizza.
Race Through New York, starring Jimmy Fallon, is set to open next year, replacing Twister Ride It Out. So one natural disaster replaces another. The facade will feature a very short version of the 30 Rock building from New York City. It's okay, though. Hong Kong Disneyland said you could always go back later and add more. No, the castle, you know, they're adding more.
Jimmy Fallon, Ride It Out.
Yeah. All right, to play me over to my virtual desk. I guess I'm at a desk already. This doesn't make a lot of sense, but Nick, play some music. Sure, put us to sleep. That'll work. Christmas.
Just like the ones I used to know.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, that's a thing. I was just checking my phone. It was on camera. All right.
You know, Connor, Connor's command over there looks like that bus that you got to try out at the
It does look like the Sorcerer bus. Did you not go in there?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, okay.
I want a quick shout out to the Anon 1189 who got the exotic butters reference. Thank you.
What is that from?
It's from Sister Location. It's a video game. Sister Location. And yes, Sunny Eclipse, it's me. Huzzah.
All right. Well, you know, folks, it's been a rough year here in Orlando. There's the theme parks have been through quite a lot. There was the fire at Volcano Bay. There's that kind of a hurricane. Zika was almost here. The Jungle Book show at Animal Kingdom. There's just been a lot of disasters this year. So, you know, we wanted Orlando to be ready for the next disaster. Certainly more prepared than they were for a hurricane. We don't want $14 box sandwiches again. That can't happen.
Or bus pizza. You know.
And we need the pizza stands at the bus stop have to be able to withstand whatever's going to come. So in order to scientifically predict what will happen to Orlando next, we have to go back to an old friend. We're bringing it back out of retirement. Please welcome back the now Wheels of Orlando theme park disaster. The ominous music, it is an incredible sight. Why is it already, it's already picked something. Yeah, thank you. Now they're okay, now we both feel it. This music, I've never heard this far into the song. Anyway, so here's the way this works. We have two wheels. The first wheel, and this is very scientific, it's controlled by a computer. The first wheel will tell us what the disaster will be. The second wheel will tell us where the disaster will be. So what and where is what we're going to find out. So, Jason, can we please turn on the machine, find out what is the next disaster in Orlando via the Wheel of Orlando theme park disasters? All right. The wheels are in motion. Let's see. We have
an
unlikely president at Space Mountain. That makes no sense.
That's too real.
This thing still doesn't work. Jason, can we try again, please? Bob Chapek idea for Cinderella Castle. Oh, no. Maybe they'll put like a second castle on top of it. I don't know.
The second castle stage.
This is a very vague.
It'll just be a Marvel overlay.
All right. Spin it again.
Anon, when do the jokes get funny? I'm still waiting.
I can't even read that.
Hold on.
Fast and the Furious Supercharged
Pandora. Too fast, too Avatar.
Spin it again.
That's the best thing I've heard about the movie. So
all for it.
What else is even on there? I don't know. There's a lot of things on that wheel. What else? Let's see. What didn't get
wheel
picked.
Crash? Yeah.
Bustle Pizza. Bustle Pizza didn't get picked. What else is there? An asteroid strike. Cabana tents.
A sinking barge.
Star Wars overlay. And what were the other locations? We had Volcano Bay, the All-Star Bus Loop, Pizza Rizzo, a dessert party. Could be any dessert party. Let's spin it. Let's spin it one more time, Jason.
Let's read the wheel.
We have a flood at Hollywood Studio.
There'll be even less left now.
Oh, boy. All right. That thing still doesn't work, Jason. It's all right.
As we've seen three times.
You know what? Let's go ahead. Let's take a commercial break. We'll be right back with more See You Relate, maybe.
The dust of 100 years awaits Indiana Jones as he examines the abandoned ruins of a once great civilization. No one has seen these sites for decades, as it has been guarded by a terrible curse.
Might as well grab a few things to bring back to the museum.
Can I help you, sir?
Whoa!
Calm down, sir. I'm just trying to take your drink order.
Drink order? In these abandoned ruins?
Sir, this is STK Orlando.
What?!
It's a restaurant.
But there's no one in it. And the sign just has three nondescript letters.
Yeah, no one's looked directly into our interior in weeks.
Comedy Warehouse is now a steakhouse. Catch the all-new STK Orlando, part of Disney Springs at the Walt Disney World Resort. The attendance problems are real.
There's not even snakes in here.
Take that, steakhouse. Oh, wait, this might be... Hold on, guys, it might be my line here. I have to check. Okay. Welcome back to See You Real Late, everyone. Now, ladies and gentlemen, tonight is a very special night as we have a great visitor from the East. The famous seer, sage, all-knowing, all-seeing, and executive producer on the BFG, ladies and gentlemen, Cornack the Magnificent.
Yes, thank you.
Welcome, oh great Cornack.
May you float upon an ice cream social.
Thanks. Now, in...
This isn't... Cornack's turban is not quite on tonight. There we go. Great.
Now, in someone's hands, not mine...
I believe Lo Cicero over there has the envelope.
There's a stack of hermetically sealed envelopes that have been... Envelopes.
Envelopes.
Envelopes. Oh, God, it's too late. Envelopes.
It's real late.
that have been stored in a pickle jar in the Tower of Terror since noon today. No one knows the contents of these envelopes, but you, in your incredibly divine way, will ascertain the answers without before seeing the questions inside these envelopes. Correct, sir?
Indeed.
Sorry, it's marked Patrick, so... Anyone can plainly see these envelopes are sealed. Nick, show the envelopes. I see them right there.
Nick has the envelopes. There they are.
So are you ready to divine the answers to the questions enclosed in all of these, as I just asked?
Yes, please bring Cornac the envelopes.
I don't have them. Nick, go ahead. Oh, he's right there. You can even see move from one camera to another like Muppet Vision.
He stepped on Reagan's foot. Are you okay, Mr. Reagan? Go ahead.
Well, yes, Tom. I'm all right.
All right. Here we go. Rogue One.
Rogue One. Tickets on sale Monday. Rogue One.
Rogue One. Describe the Lotus float in Rivers of Light. Rogue One. Where's it going? I don't know.
Rogue sunk.
Time for a cast preview. The second envelope. Jingle bell, jingle bam. Jingle bell, jingle bam. Name Emeril Lagasse's holiday cookbook. They're not all art.
Well, it sounds like a joke, but that's actually the name of a show, people.
Yep. That's the real joke. It's holiday. Ant-Man!
Ant-Man.
Ant-Man.
Paul Rudd, as it were.
What will all of the performers in Festival of Fantasy look like from the Riverboat Ice Cream Social? Very far away.
Nah, because Ant-Man can also grow big, so...
But that came later. Let's not dwell on Ant-Man's other powers, shall we?
This joke is several years old.
Wind Traders, that's the Pandora store, not the jewelry.
Oh, I didn't even remember.
What is the next hobby Disney will try to sell us on? You would like to buy some wind? The upsell on this is amazing.
It's a limited edition.
Bob JPEG's got a lot of hot air. The 2017 Epcot International Food and Wine Festival. At this point, is there even anything else that could possibly open before Pandora, the world of Avatar? 2017.
Well,
Food and Wine Festival.
Not Avatar 2.
That's true. Aren't they just going to be a week apart, 2, 3, 4, and 5?
Maybe.
Isn't that the plan?
Do they ever get out? Jeez.
Fuel rod. Who was the only rod left in DCA?
Rod Serling is getting replaced by David Bautista.
This, as you may recognize, is a really poor bit.
That we stole.
We did. Oh, I like this. That I'm looking through the beads tonight. This hat's all messed up. Time for a new one, I think. Bus stop pizza.
Bus. I can't eat anymore.
Bus stop. Shut up, Scott. Bus stop pizza. How did Elvis die?
Please drink or eat bus stop pizza in moderation.
Now for the seventh and final envelope. Yeah, seventh. You jerks.
Intense.
How are people describing the Magic Kingdom cabanas? Intense.
Yeah,
you're in a tent.
That's It's not even a joke. It's a literal statement. Hi-oh, Cornax, right, magnificent ladies and gentlemen.
Cornax says let's take a commercial break, and we'll be back with our guest.
Hello there. Do you like fish? How about pillaging? Is your idea of a good time the sacking and slaughter of your enemies? Do you feel that a civilization can only best be seen through black lights? Do you feel that every citizen of Norway is either a Viking, a cruise director, or oil worker? If you said yes to any of these questions, then listen up. The land and food of Norway have always been and always will be full of peril and adventure. And nowhere is this more evident than here at Maelstrom. At Maelstrom, you will experience the most authentic Norwegian dining experience you can imagine. And it starts when you walk in the front door, past the moat, and through the gauntlet of flags. I tell you, there's nothing like this place in the world.
Except maybe ask yourself.
Quiet, Loki! Don't believe me. Ask one of our satisfied customers.
Well, the food was good, I guess, and, well, I think they undercooked my mutton flanks.
What? No problem. Olaf, take these back. Back to the kitchen and get this fixed. Sorry about that, sir. Did I mention that the spirit of Norway has always been and always will be adventure? Here at Maelstrom, we have plenty of themed dining rooms that really take you back to the old country, like the Norwegian fishing village, the medieval Norwegian fishing village, the enchanted second a full service bar staffed by a real polar bear. Say hi, Pierre. Here at the Lazy Eye Bar, everything is served in three sizes. Large, really large, and please pick Volstagg off the floor. You just ask our bartender to make it. He'll stare at you blankly, but wow, you just talked to a polar bear.
What's this? How dare you send this food back?
This is troll cuisine. I cast a spell! You will disappear! Disappear! Disappear!
Well then, if this sounds like a restaurant for you, then come on down to Maelstrom. You aren't the first to come this way. But you may be the last.
The Maelstrom is located at 1988 Avenue of the Stars, Orlando, Florida. Just tell them Fjord sent you.
Oldest commercial.
Yeah. It's a classic.
That is a classic.
Yeah. Am I going to? There we go. Welcome back to See You Real 8. We have mugs. Anyway, we spare no expense.
I've got the Hulk on my cup.
You do have the Hulk on your cup. Scott has like a kid's birthday party cup. So you got to show it now. You're on camera.
99 cents. Oh. It's the Hulk.
Scott, we're happy to have you. Happy to have see you relate. Oh, jeez. Something's never changed. We're happy to have see you relate back this evening as part of the 45-hour broadcast of Benefit Toys for Tots, a 45-hour celebration of 45 years of Walt Disney World. Of course, the purpose of this whole show is to raise money for Toys for Tots. So how do you do that? You go to toys.wdwnt.com, and that's how you donate through First Giving. It's this wonderful organization that makes sure the money goes directly to that charity. So make sure you do that. That's the whole reason we're here. If you're enjoying the show tonight, even if you think it's terrible, you should give to this wonderful charity. Again, toys.wdwnt.com. Please donate. And of course, so much more show to come. Directly following See You Real 8, we have the world premiere of our Jeopardy, the WDWNT edition. And then there's a full slate of shows the next 2 days, the next 43 hours after this. That are still yet to go. So it's pretty exciting. But yeah, anyway, thank you for joining us. So let's get to our guest this evening. Our guest this evening is the host of Radio Free Disneyland, the newest original show from right here at WDWNT. Please welcome to the program, DJ Middlebrow.
Good evening, gentlemen.
Evening.
We had to play a little Pooh for President to bring you in honor of the third episode coming up.
That's right. That's the third episode is called The President of Disneyland.
Yeah. So for those people listening that don't know what Radio Free Disneyland is, I know it's a little bit out there. Try your best to explain to people what Radio Free Disneyland is.
Well, you know, some things are possibly better said with music. And so we try to tell stories with music that isn't necessarily Disney music. There's certainly some Disney music in the show, but I think it was proven last night by anyone that or can be attested to by anyone who watched that special on TV last night that Disney isn't always maybe the best source of music.
Yeah, I didn't even watch it last night. I was so busy prepping this disaster, but yeah.
I had no idea it even happened. Was that
I did not hear good things. There's one tonight too. We missed the Descendants Christmas special tonight on the Disney Channel.
I saw pieces of the first one. It was garbage.
Oh, we didn't miss it. It's on my DVR. Don't worry.
Oh, okay.
Worry. Nick's going to be doing the commentary tomorrow at 4 a.m. Make sure you're online, Nick, doing the commentary on the Descendants Christmas special. But so, yeah, DJ, when you pitched this show, you said it originally said to me, well, it's not a lot of Disney music. It's music that maybe sounds like it fits.
Well, it could certainly be that in some cases. And then I think maybe one of my favorite tunes that's going to be in the president of Disneyland episode is the Desolation theme, which is probably the darkest song in the Disney canon. It comes from Pinocchio after island is destroyed by its own. Yeah, so that's we're going to use there's a few real Disney songs in the episode coming up.
Very cool. So the two episodes that are out and available now, the first one sets up the story of this show, and it's the discovery of Disneyland. And can you explain a little bit the backstory and maybe where this whole backstory came from? Because I know when we released the episode, the feedback was mostly, this is amazing, but also this backstory is really out there.
Well, I work for some people. They believe that Disneyland is an American principality. Now, a principality is a small country generally that's run by a prince. And they believe that Disneyland is an American principality. And they would like to get some revenge for the Radio Free Disneyland thing that went on in the 40s and 50s and on through there. Mm-hmm. And we are basically jamming Disneyland with Radio Free Disneyland. We're speaking our mind, and we're telling the true stories of Disneyland, and we're doing it with music.
Very cool.
Does that make any sense?
No, it does to me. But I think I have the benefit of having heard the first two episodes so far, and I think people, if they want to make more sense of that, will just have to go and download that first episode.
There you go.
Yeah.
And get on the boat.
And I love that you know, the first episode's about the discovery of Disneyland, but then the second episode, you jump right into a Cars Land-themed episode. That being said, there's certainly a lot in the Disney history that's car culture-related, going back to the World's Fair, and even before that, the Autopia. So
Right. Explain
how that idea comes together that we're gonna teach your employers about car culture and how an episode like that comes together.
Well, I think that, you know, really, honestly, that episode had a lot to do with Cars Land. You know, Cars Land has, and a lot of the Disney parks now have these kind of, what would the word be, kind of advanced background music systems. Mm. And there are so many great car songs. And, you know, in Cars Land at the Disneyland Resort, the background music loops are great. And so I wanted to kind of use some of the things that were there tell that story, and then also add some ones that we may think are missing.
And see, that's immediately what I thought of when you originally said there'd be a lot of non-Disney music. Certainly, there are several background loops and even retired ones at this point that were filled with real world music. So a lot of the stuff that plays in Cars Land is real songs released about cars. Like there's
right.
You know, I'm trying to think of a couple off the top of my head. I can't even.
Well, you know, there's a new background music loop in the Disney California Adventure Park in the Smoke Jumpers Grill. Mm-hmm. And I would love if there was a bar that had the music that place has. It's it's almost all honky tonk music. Mm. And I would love for they should turn that place into a bar. It'd be I'd right. hang out
and
there.
And it's DCA, so they certainly can.
That's true. It competes with any great bar jukebox that anyone's ever seen.
I do love. They also they have the radio in the car across the street. I don't know what kind of car that is, but the car sitting across the street. If you walk up
Rambler.
Close enough, yeah. If you walk up close enough, you'll hear the radio playing through the car, which is pretty neat.
So, I have a question for you. Mm-hmm. Now, you guys are maintaining that there really is a place called Walt Disney World.
Yes.
Okay, because we you know, in our little group here that's running Radio Free Disneyland, we're not ready to completely acknowledge that there really is such a place. So, what can you tell me about this that might convince us that there really is such a place?
Probably the marketing materials out there.
Well,
go to a vacation club booth.
I don't know. Well, I mean, things like bus stop pizza. He's gonna have to convince me that it exists.
What if I told you there was a place where you could, before boarding a bus, buy a full pizza pie?
See, I wouldn't believe it.
No. Well, I mean, so you're saying that there is really a Disney park complex that has five parks and. How many hotels? 30 something.
Well, six parks if you count the two water parks.
Well, that's true. Yeah. So, I mean, you know, I listen to all this information. I say, get out of here. I mean, come on. I mean, listen to yourselves. There couldn't really be such a place, could there?
I don't know. Maybe Radio Free Disneyland someday will have to come explore.
I think you're right. Now I am doing a little bit of research on that. I have found I have ordered a map, a Russian map of Orlando. Now during the Cold War,
was that from Splendid Russia? That was a local attraction, wasn't it, Nick? Splendid. Oh, that was Splendid China. I'm sorry.
Anyway. I have ordered a map, a Russian map. There are such a thing as Russian maps. I have one of Anaheim, and I think you may have seen it on some kind of collateral material that's around Radio Free Disneyland. Mm-hmm. Apparently, during the Cold War, Russia completely mapped the whole world, including the United States, down to the nth degree. You know, they wanted to make sure, you know, they could get the tanks up Harbor Boulevard. So
people can't get their cars up Harbor Boulevard. I'm not sure.
No, I know. Well, yeah, during certain times of the day. So I do have a Russian map of Anaheim, and I do have a Russian map of Orlando as part of my research to try to confirm this idea that there really is such a place as Walt Disney World.
So right now, episodes 1 and 2 are available. They're on iTunes. Episode 2 is actually on YouTube also, actually. But now episode 3, we're going to debut on Sunday, hopefully.
Right.
That on Sunday. What can we expect from this third episode, which is called The President of Disneyland?
Well, it's our attempt to really kind of nail down who is really the president of Disneyland. Is it Michael Cole Glazier? Is it Mr. Lincoln? Is it Richard Nixon? You know, there's a lot of supporting evidence that Richard Nixon may have really been the president of Disneyland, if you want to look at it in that way. He was somebody that was well known and associated with the park. There are even, you know, kind of unsubstantiated stories that after he was out of the presidency and living in San Clemente, that he would come up with the Secret Service kind of at nighttime and go to the park. Hmm. And, you know, and you know, his press secretary, who was the, you know, the White House press secretary, was a former Jungle Cruise skipper. So there's a lot of sort of supporting evidence that Richard Nixon could be considered the president of Disneyland. So we're trying to kind of compare these different types of people. You know, John F. Kennedy held a kind of a summit, a meeting with I believe it was the president of Guyana at Disneyland. He thought that would be a good place. He wasn't president at the time. He was still a senator.
Yeah.
But he thought Disneyland would be a good place to, probably a casual place to meet somebody and have a good talk. So we look at different kinds of places where, you know, different presidents, different types of presidents, people who were actually presidents of the park, like George Kalogridis and our current the current president out here, Michael Cole Glacier. So we're kind of looking at different kinds of presidents, and we're sort of, in a way, saying who is the president of Disneyland.
All right. Well, what can we expect from the music selection in this episode?
I think my favorite song kind of came along a little later in the process, an opportunity to kind of take this, this subject, in the hand and maybe take the current election, in the hand a little bit. And it's a Leonard Cohen song. Leonard Cohen just passed away a couple weeks ago, and it's called, and it could be the slogan of the new president of the United States. The song's called First We Take Manhattan, Then We Take Berlin. So, so you know, you might look at that. That sounds a little familiar.
Well, it should be another interesting episode of Radio Free Disneyland. Of course, if people want to hear it, you can search Radio Free Disneyland on iTunes. It's also available at WDWNT.com in the podcast section. And we're going to debut that. I don't have the time in front of me right now, but Sunday during this broadcast, we're looking to debut episode 3 of Radio Free Disneyland. So people, you still got quite a few hours to catch up before that.
There you go.
But DJ, thank you so much. We're loving the show. Such tremendous feedback, and we're looking forward to a lot more Radio Free Disneyland.
Well, great. If I am able to actually prove the existence of Walt Disney World, you will be the first one I call.
All right. Sounds good. DJ All Middlebrow, right, thank you, everybody. All right.
There we go.
There it is. The Yay. We're done with Serial 8. Yay. It kind of worked.
Worked really well.
Jingle meh. give me a little play out music there, Gomer. Thank you. Of course, some housekeeping notes on the show. Of course, if you have any questions, suggestions, comments, or concerns, social media is a great place to voice them. Follow us on Twitter at twitter.com/WDWNT or at WDWNT, and of course we're on Facebook at facebook.com/WDW News Today. Don't forget to visit us online at WDWNT.com, and that's what I got. Nick and Scott, you got anything to plug?
Sure. JediHeroPrincess.com. great stuff there. NintendoDiaries.com, whatever you want.
Are you still doing that? Are you doing a TV show one still?
FlashDiaries.com. We do a podcast on Timeless Diaries.
I don't even know what that is. Oh, that's that NBC so show, isn't it?
So good.
Yeah.
Check it all out. Thank you.
Scott, you got anything to plug?
I got a new Twitter at the circumstances. I need to restart my Twitter. It's tough to be a pug
That's my name on Twitter.
It's tough to be a pug.
I'm going to, for the parade, I'm going to pitch it to Disney. We'll see if they pick it up. Nutria Live Show. Tough to be a pug.
Let's see if they can finish Rivers of Light
first and then maybe. So, Tough to be a pug on Twitter. Also, twitter.com/acnoproject, A-C-N-O project is a comic I work on. That's about it.
Connor Perzicki, you're a big idiot. Look at this.
I'll go say
the best $10 we ever spent. Right? I want to thank everybody for making See You Real 8 possible. I know video See You Real 8 is a huge undertaking, and it takes a team to put this thing together, and I appreciate everybody helping out with it. And hopefully those of you at home enjoyed it. And I assure you, by next summer, See You Real 8 will be back on a more regular schedule. I know we said that at the 10th anniversary show. We said next summer, and so next summer, stay tuned. It's going to happen. But with that being said, that's going to do it for this time. We'll see you all next time. We'll see you real late.
And beyond a doubt, my heart will lead me there soon. Oh, we'll meet, I know we'll meet beyond the shore. We'll kiss just as before. Happy we will be beyond the sea. And never again I'll go sailing. No more sailing. So long sailing, sailing. No more sailing. Goodbye, farewell, my friend. No more sailing. So long sailing. No more sailing. No more farewell. Auf Wiedersehen, adieu, adieu, adieu. No more sailing. No more. Oh, no more sailing. No more, no more. No more sailing. No more. One more time. No more sailing.